Welcome, everybody. My name is Tamela Tressel, and I founded the TLC Education, and it is an organization that develops predominantly environmental and science courses and classes and field adventures. And sometimes we do other great fun things, like we put on a wonderful field day, usually in May, and other fun things like that. I have been doing Tai Chi for about 10 years in Qigong, and have found it to be extremely helpful to me in many areas, which you will learn about. And I hope that after today's session, you get an interest in it and seek other opportunities to learn more about it yourself. I am also docked through the summer camp to teach you about what's under your feet, soils. So I hope you come to that one, and what's in your water. Those are gonna be really fun, informative classes that I think you're gonna enjoy a lot. So can I have you guys type in chat what you think Qigong and Tai Chi is and what you think its purpose is? Great, so martial arts and martial arts poses, no clue, karate, very good. Karate but calm. All right, it seems like some of you have some awareness of what it's kind of about. So that is fantastic. All right, we're going to begin with a prezi. I don't know if any of you have ever put one together, but they're kind of cool. They're a different form of PowerPoint that's going to introduce us to a little bit more about Tai Chi. So give me one second here to share my screen and get that pulled up. There it is. All right, can everybody see the young man holding this up? Okay, Qigong and Tai Chi began as a lot of you seem to be aware, as a martial art over 2,500 years ago. And it is made up of a series of body movements that are used to, in relationship to your breath and with meditation, to help you with your health, your mind, and your body. It's often used in a big group of people today. In China, there will be thousands of people that will come to these big open courtyards and do it. In the picture here, you can see them performing it on the beach. I love to do Tai Chi on the beach, by the way. Okay. One of the first three things, as I mentioned before, that Tai Chi helps us with are health benefits. So it helps you to clear your head and have bring a sense of tranquility and peace and calm. And these things help lower your blood pressure, help your immune system, and help your all the functions in your body flow and work better. There are some studies that say it also helps with things like your heart and your depression, if and other things as well. The second thing that it helps with is your mind. During and after participating in the forms that of Tai Chi and Qigong, it will bring you that serenity I was talking about and that peace, which clears your mind and therefore gives you focus, gives you the ability to focus. And when you can focus and concentrate better, you're able to learn better, understand and comprehend better, and you're able to think creatively as well. Along with health and improvement of the mind, it also is very useful to, of course, your physical fitness and your body. Although it does help with aerobics, that isn't its primary physical benefit to the body. It does give you an increase in your energy levels and your stamina, flexibility, and balance. And it comes from within. It works on you within. You can think of a river that's calm on top, but underneath it has a lot of energy and is churning. And that's what it helps you do. So it builds up that energy that can then just be transferred to whatever other tasks you need to go to. So although Tai Chi is that slow moving martial arts, which it once came from, it will give you energy to maybe mow the lawn or play your soccer game or swim or take a test. And so it that's a really neat thing to get energy. You don't think of getting energy from something that's more calm and peaceful, but that's a benefit. The four different types of fitness that it improves, it is your muscle strength, your flexibility, your balance, and if you do it quickly or over a long period of time, it can help aerobically as well. So how does it help your muscle strength? Well, when you practice it regularly, it's similar to resistance training and brisk walking. And you will be in a form that you can sink yourself lower and build up your leg muscles. And it works all the fine muscles as well as the large muscle groups as well. It helps with your flexibility and helps you move more easily because it will circulate the blood flow, your lymphs, and it increases your healing in your muscles too, so they can get stronger when you are doing those more physically active things. It's very excellent for improving your balance because it works with your sensory neurons in your ear and your stretch receptors in your muscles and ligaments that help you get your balance. So, to recap, Tai Chi benefits our health, our mind, and our bodies. And it does this through slow sequential movements that have no beginning and no end to them. They're in a continuum like a floating river. And like that river, there's a sense of energy that they bring to your body that's inside, underneath that calm surface that we're seeing on the outside, because it as we'll see when you guys are actually going to do some Qigong and Tai Chi with me in just a moment, the control that you have to have will give you a serene, peaceful look, but it's a lot of work. Okay, so if you don't mind, I want you to take one question poll. Question one, it says, what are three benefits of Tai Chi and Qigong? Actually, it should say two. Should say two benefits. Give everyone a little while to take that poll. Change it to a two. If you're not familiar with polls, the question is, what are the two benefits that you get from Tai Chi and Qigong? And your options to choose from are improve your speed, clear focus, and improve fitness, or two of the choices, which we already said there's two. So which two of those choices are the correct answer? Improve speed, clear focus, and improve fitness.
Okay, we're going to close the poll in about another 10 seconds and then continue. All right, it looks like almost everybody voted.
All right, well, thank you guys. Okay, you guys can see what the results are. And the answer is that it gives us clear focus and improved fitness. Now, which one is missing? Do you guys remember the other one? Because clear focus is your mind, and fitness would be your body. So which is your third bubble that was in our presentation? And it would have been that first one. Do you guys remember what that was? Put it in chat. Yeah, excellent. It's health. So although Tai Chi isn't known for improving speed and that's not the major focus of it, I think it actually can improve your speed indirectly by helping all those other attributes of your sense of balance and working all those small muscle groups and not just the large muscle groups. And so that, I think, does help with improving your speed, although that's not the major initiative of doing it. All right, we can close those poll results down there. So what I'd like everyone to do now is to join me with getting ready to do some Qigong. But before I do that, does anybody have any questions or comments that they would like to make in the chat? Shik, if you could just let me know. All right, so if you're sitting down, everybody get up, walk to a space where you can stand up and have about two or three spaces of walking paces left and right and back and forward as my space that you can see I have. So I can walk one, two, three spaces, and I can walk one, two to the side, and one, two to the side. All right, okay. So the first thing that I want to begin with is Qigong. Qigong helps prepare us for Tai Chi. And the first position is what's called Wuji. Wuji is basically getting a sense of groundedness. And that's very important before you begin. I don't know if any of you had many years ago, I'm not really good at gaming, but it was, they had one of those platforms that you would stand on, a Wii Fit maybe? Maybe that was it. And you would try to get your weight balanced so you weren't tilted left to right and you weren't tilted forward to back, but exactly straight up and down. So that's what I want you to do. Put your feet shoulder width apart. And then center your weight. So you're right in the middle. Now I want you to slowly bend your knees. I want you to be able to see me. Okay, so now with your knees bent, I want you to scan your body. A lot of times, I close my eyes, and other people in the class at AGM, we close our eyes to do this, because when you close your eyes, you can really focus. You're gonna begin focusing on your head. And I want you to feel, with your eyes closed, how does your head feel? Now move down. How does your neck feel? Your shoulders? Your chest? How does your belly feel? Got any cramps and squeezes in there? And how about your back? Is it tight? Did you maybe lay in bed wrong or sit wrong? What about your pelvis? Your legs, knees, ankles, feet, and toes. Now I want you to open your eyes back up. Now, do you feel balanced, centered left to right, in front to back? We're going to begin with breath next. You're going to take a slow inhale as you raise your arms out to the side and up above you, and then we'll bring them down in front of us. Now, as we do this, as our legs raise, our knees are going to raise. And as our arms will lower, our knees will lower. So we're gonna act like waves of the ocean. So inhale. Exhale, slowly bending your knees along with your arms coming down. Inhale. Keep inhaling, inhale, inhale. Exhale. And one more time, big, slow inhale. Let your belly extend when you do this. I wanna see Buddha bellies, big, big bellies. And exhale. And on the exhale, you pull your belly in. And you resume the Wuji posture. Next, we start at the top of our heads to loosen our head and our necks. Tilt your head to the left. Now, I'm not very flexible in my neck. You guys, I'm sure, are a lot more flexible, but you're gonna tilt your chin up while your head's tilted to the left. Now, tilt your chin down. Slowly raise your head to the center. Tilt it to the right. My head's really tight here. I slept on it wrong and oof, it's that pool right there. But that's why this is so good. Tilt your chin up. Sounds like ground sand in my neck. and tilt it down. Slowly raise your head up. You're going to open your mouth and gently drop your head back. Bring it back up. Okay, I hope your neck feels better. Now we're going to raise our arms out to the side like we did before. Now you're going to put your palms facing out. Now you're going to face them behind you. You should still have knees bent and your body centered. Notice, did you get off balance? You're going to make what's called sword hands. That's where two fingers are together and my thumb is covering my pinky and my ringy finger. You're going to bring those sword hands down to the side. Drop your shoulders. You don't want your shoulders up by your ears. You want to release and let go of the tension. Roll backwards. I want you to put a paintbrush on the end of your swords. Pick any color you want. And make small little circles. You can have a different color on each hand if you want. Now let's go forward with it instead of back. Pause. Turn your hands over. Release sword hands to open palms. Squeeze your fingers together to make what kind of looks like a bird beak. Bring that bird beak to the little divot underneath your collarbone, between your shoulder bone. Now, move those paintbrushes to the end of your elbows. Instead of making little circles, we're going to paint big circles. Once again, anytime you want, you may close your eyes and you can visualize big circles. And let's see how big we can get those circles. So pull your elbows in. Make them go all the way above your head and back. Let's do one more. Great, now let's rotate. Bring them forward. Now, before we were stretching our chest, now we're stretching our back. I know my children did school and sitting is very fatiguing on the body. And this feels so good to get up and do these movements. All right, shoulders back out. Let go of those paintbrushes. Open palms. Push down until you hit your invisible table, which is at the level of your right below your navel. We call that area the Dong Tien. That's where all energy is derived and flowing. You're going to pull your arms back behind you and you're going to make circles. Pretend you're on a nice level table. Great. Let's go the other direction. Push forward and fold back and bring them forward and back. Now, if you're a male, you put your left hand first and then your right hand. If you're a female, you put your right hand and then your left hand. Now remember, I'm reversed from you because of the camera. And you want to line up your long wu points, which is this part right here in the middle of your palm if you were to cup it. Line them up at your Dong Tien. Straighten your legs. This is one of my favorite exercises in Qigong. I do this all the time when I have to stand a lot and sit a lot. You're going to begin rotating your hips. And once again, you're going to try and make a nice circle with your hips. So it's not side to side. I'm pushing forward, then to the side, then to the back. but I'm not sticking out my butt exactly. Let's see if you can see it from this view. My knees, although they're straight, they're not locked. You don't want to lock your knees. Okay, let's go the other direction. Reverse the direction. Wonderful. Breathe in, raise your arms up. Now, exhale, breathe out. And bend your knees while bringing your hands to your knees. We're gonna loosen up our hips and our knees. So make circles with your knees. And reverse the direction. Okay, now we're going to see if we can touch the floor. I won't be able to my first time. Breathe in. Now exhale and go a little further. Breathe in. Exhale and go a little further. Bend your knees and raise up. Great job. Now I want you to straddle out a little past shoulder width. And you are going to get into what's called the horse riding stance. So pretend you're on a nice big horse. Horses have big, broad backs. So you want to keep your body upright, your chest upright. You don't want to be leaned over and having your bum sticking out. You want to be upright and legs up. Your knees should be over your ankles, not over your toes. You're just going to hold this posture for a little while with your hands nice, round, soft way in front of your dantian, your lower abdomen. Does anybody feel this is getting a little bit hard? The longer you stay here, the more muscles you build up in those legs. But we're not going to stay here too long because we got to move on to Tai Chi. So I'm just doing this Qigong, a little teeny bit of the routine I do. So now though, before we get up, you're going to sink low, 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 as low as you can go, and sit. You can push your legs out like this, or you can do this. Now raise up with your hands on the floor, and you can walk your feet back out, and then you're just gonna bend over. And up, and I can see time is flying by much faster than I thought it would. So we're going to stop our Qigong, move right into Tai Chi, do a couple of forms, parting wild horse's mane and brush mane. So that kind of went from top to bottom. We didn't finish our bottom with our Qigong, but you kind of get the idea. Now, I told you Tai Chi is a fluid motion that's nonstop. So I'm gonna demonstrate first, and then you'll do it too. One of the things that all Tai Chi movements have though is this J step. So that's what I'm gonna teach you, is the J step. So coming out of Wuji, you're gonna bring your weight to the left-hand side, and just watch me first, and you're gonna lift your leg, and you're gonna make a reverse J. So it starts bringing it into your ankle, coming out and going over, and then place your heel down. Push forward. Now, you're going to bring your weight back, turn your foot out, push the weight back onto that foot, and now you're on the other side, ready to do a J step. Come out, put the heel down, push forward. Okay, so try this with me. In Wuji, shift your weight to your left side. Bring your foot into your ankle. foot out, into a J, heel down. Push your weight forward, bring your weight back, push it forward, and keep pushing, pushing, pushing. You see my foot lifts off, and I J step to the other side. Heel down, come back, lift my front toe, push the weight back onto that foot, keep pushing, pushing, pushing. My other foot comes up to the heel. J step out, heel down. Okay, now we need to do something with these arms because they're bored, right? Okay, we're gonna do parting wild horse's mane. So we're in Wuji. Put your weight to the left. Bring your foot into your ankle. Make your reverse J step. Toes up, heel down. Push your weight while doing your arms like that. Then pull your weight back. Make a small ball to the other side. J step, heel down, and forward. Pull back, small ball. J step, forward. So I don't know if there's a hard deadline, Chip. Can you tell me what it is? Are they signing off now?
You're all right. We're still good for a little while.
Okay. So let's just do hands real quick, because I know that might have been hard to put them both together. So just stand in your Wuji form. You make a small ball by one arm with your palm down, one arm with your palm up. And then you just simply slip them past each other. Now this hand that's palm up, it wants to face down, and this palm that's face down wants to face up. So they come in, and there they go. And then they slip past each other. Let's try that again. Small ball, palms face each other, slip past each other. Small ball, slip past each other. Okay, get in your root stance. We'll put them together. Weight shift to the right. Make your small ball. Bring your left foot to the ankle, or your reverse for me, so it's probably your right foot. Make your J step. Push the weight forward as you slide your hands apart. Bring your weight back and push it back forward, making a small ball as your weight comes up. Step out, J step, slide past. Do another one. Well done. I'm going to pause here and see if there are any questions so far. Does anybody have any questions? Maybe it might be hard to type it all in. I don't know if you want to raise a hand and Chip can give you the mic privilege.
Yeah, we don't seem to have any questions. Zakari, you said that you're in pain. If you're doing something and it hurts, stop. This is all about listening to your body.
Absolutely.
Alex said this is great. Now, Veronica wanted to know, how do you spell this? So I know you mentioned Tai Chi. Now, how would you go about spelling? And I don't want to get the...
There's so many ways to spell it, just so you know. And I, in my Prezi, I didn't put them all. The more Western way of spelling Tai Chi is T-A-I and then C-H-I. That's Tai Chi. Now for Qigong, it's Q I, and then gong like ringing a gong. G-O-N-G. So to wrap up, I just want to show you a tiny piece of the 24. The 24 is an international form that gets performed all over the world. And in April, I believe it's the second Saturday in April, it literally gets performed all over the world. So I'm from Carlisle. Here in Carlisle, we have a Tai Chi Day gathering at the different local parks, and they do it. I'm sure in your community, they probably have one, or close in your community, they also have one. So that's something that you can look into. Just do World Tai Chi Day in your Google, and I can guarantee you they will be performing the 24. So if you want to continue on with Qigong and Tai Chi, you'll want to start and begin with the universal Yan form. Because there's, remember, we talked, there are five different kinds of Chen form, or of Tai Chi forms. Chen being one, Yan, Sun, Wu. But this 24 is called the Yan form. It's big, expansive, open form. Okay, so you'll want to Google Tai Chi 24 form. I'm going to perform just a little bit of that, and we'll sign off. I won't do the whole thing. The whole thing takes about 6 minutes. There are 24 postures. I'm just going to do the very beginning, okay? So we start off in our Wuji. Actually, you start off with your heels together. Then you move to Wuji. And as I'm doing this, if you have any questions, just put your hand, raise your hand up. I'm going to be making my movements really small, or I'm going to go off the screen. So basically, I would do this parting wild horse's mane three times. And then I would do what's called white crane. And then brush knee, which is similar to parting wild horse's mane, but not really. Now this is called repulsing monkey. And I would do that four times. And then I get into a small ball. There are kinks in Tai Chi too. This is called snakes creeps down. My plant's in the way. All right. Well, I don't want to exceed our time by too much. So unless there are any other questions that you have for me, we'll have to call it a day. And I don't know if they have any other time in this camp to have another session. But you can reach out to Schick and PABCS and ask.
Hey, thank you so much, Ms. Tamela, for showing us all this wonderful stuff and getting us calmer and centered and starting our Monday off right.
Yeah.
Now, if you do have any more questions, I mean, please feel free to ask. A lot of people are just saying thanks for teaching us, Alex, Luke, Francis, so Danielle, thank you so much, guys, for attending and being interactive. I wanted to tell you about a couple more things that we have going on throughout the week. So let me just post our link here for the summer camp. And what we have going on for the rest of this week is we have a backyard games presentation tomorrow. So a PA virtual teacher, Lindsay Bernstein, who teaches phys ed, she's going to do some stuff on backyard games, stuff that you could do at your house and games that you could create. That's going to be a lot of fun. Now on Wednesday, we are actually going to a bake shop and we're going to see the ins and outs of a coffee and bake shop and also make some super fun brownies. So I will be posting the ingredients on our Facebook page and on our webpage as well, but we'll be posting the recipe afterwards as well. All of these are recorded, so you can watch the recording and bake your brownies yourself which will be a lot of fun. And then Thursday, we have your own print shop, which is we're going to show you how to make your own stickers, how to make your own flipbook. And that is going to be with Eileen Stroh of Alpha Graphics over in Allentown. So you can sign up for any of those for free at the summer camp webpage that I just shared with everybody. And beyond that, just want to remind you, on that page, you can download your passport as well. Ms. Tamela, is there anything else that you wanted to share?
Nope. You guys just have a great, safe summer and have a lot of fun enjoying these wonderful camps provided by PA Virtual.
Yep. And Ms. Tamela is going to be back for some other stuff that we'll be doing a little differently throughout the summer too. So until tomorrow, I know a few of you who I've seen you every day, such as Luke and Veronica and Liam. I hope I see you tomorrow. All the rest of you who are here as well. And I know I only named three. I know a lot of you come every day. But I hope to see you again tomorrow and throughout the week. And just a reminder, Friday, the school is closed due to 4th of July. So we will not have a session on Friday. Have a great and wonderful day. If I don't see you, have a beautiful week too, and happy 4th of July. And I will talk to all of you soon. And one final note, if you do have some other questions, I am going to stick around for a few minutes, whether it be about this or the school. Please feel free to text me. But beyond that, have a beautiful day, everybody.